TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Laura Sanko inside Fight Church here tonight in Kansas City, Kansas. Harrison in the red. King in the black.
I'm surprised to see Courtney sort of closing distance already. And one thing Courtney has had going for her in a striking is she does some unorthodox same side triple, double, triple strikes, which can kind of, it can make for a chaotic environment and make it hard for an opponent to track her head.
Nice kick to the body, finds a home for Harrison. Tommy Toehold checking in on Twitter. He's always here on Invicta FC Fight Night.
And if you keep an eye on the outside leg, it'd be Harrison's right leg, Courtney's left, and you watch who's trying to kind of outpace each other, outstep each other there. That's going to show us where most of the power shots can be effective in these exchanges. Kayla Harrison has some very powerful kicks, too, and from this open stance, I mean, that body kick is just going to be money for her.
Takedown attempt there early by Harrison. King able to stay on her feet, but now in the clinch.
Sometimes those small victories early on, though, are so important when, you know, you're fighting someone who's just, again, has that aura of, oh, she can take down anybody. That small victory of her not getting that takedown immediately, that's great for Courtney King.
It really is great. And, you know, it's just, the, like you said, those small victories kind of can have her mount her own offense like that, or can help her have some more confidence in herself when mounting an offense. I like the way Harrison changed that, in, or chained, excuse me, chained that takedown attempt into a strike.
Harrison chooses to disengage, go back to space. Interesting tactic here. When you look at Kayla Harrison, you mentioned the world-class, elite-level judo background. I mean, Courtney King really can't even bring in anyone that can match that technique to get ready. And there's a just beautiful just throw down there by Kayla Harrison. Nice right hand as she enters the guard here of King.
And one of the things I really admire about Harrison's game is the way she is incorporating massive ground and pound, like you can see there from
Oh, and there's
positions.
Some blood cut open here is Courtney King.
That's a big cut.
You see Courtney King scrambling to break the posture and also trap the arm. That's going to be hard to do when somebody has their hips pushed into you like that. She's trying to pull her head down. Now she's digging for that.
Yeah, the blood gushing here.
Got distracted.
Oh, hard right elbow again by Kayla Harrison. King in some serious trouble.
Kayla just so vicious in this top position. She does such a good job of following the hips and just landing offense the entire time that she's on top of you, just relentlessly.
Just 2 minutes remain here in round number one, but that is an eternity here for Courtney King to survive. Marcia La Silva taking a look at that cut. Coming alive with right hands is Kayla Harrison.
It's just when you can generate that kind of ground and pound, it's having such an innate sense of yourself and physics and where you can actually execute that strike and have gravity behind you, right? Because it's a short distance, but if you can flip over or if you can get that elbow exactly perfect, those are some money shots.
And that's what judo is all about, right, Julie? It's physics. And understanding that leverage on the feet is often translates to understanding on the ground as well.
Credit to Courtney King. I mean, her eyes are just closed. She's trying to survive. A touch over a minute remains here.
But like I said, pin and pound right here. This is where Harrison's biggest statement can be made in this cage, I think, is, and quite literally leave an indelible mark. It's just the statement with what she can do and how she can adapt.
I'm out here, hard right hands. Kayla Harrison maybe putting in the finishing touches. Courtney King trying to survive. Harrison being very patient here.
Courtney's still intelligently defending, but this fight does seem in a dangerous place for her.
I think that this is close to being stopped for at least a doctor's check. But there's 30 seconds left. They may.
That's a good point.
Now maybe armbar here for Kayla Harrison.
They're very slippery.
Courtney King trying to survive, as you mentioned, very slippery with this blood. We'll see if she can try to utilize something to get free, but Kayla Harrison trying to wrap up the victory right here.
She created a nice frame for herself to make it hard for Harrison to actually extend that. So she's able to keep her elbows locked together, almost like a rear naked choke on her own arm.
But
well, the stoppage may not be coming here, guys. That was a statement. Courtney King is a survivor, and she starts round number two. We'll see if she can try to change the tide of this fight. 10-8 across the board. Laura Sanko, no surprise there.
Yeah, TJ, I was reminded that they don't use elbows in PFL. So, I mean, man, Kayla Harrison with a brand new weapon tonight, and she's putting it to use.
I think she's drilled it.
I think so. But, I mean, it's got to be nice for her to be able to use that in a fight finally.
Oh, 100%. And that's something that you can't drill in the room like that.
No.
It's not full force. And we're seeing a whole new layer to the game of Kayla Harrison. Nice takedown here inside the guard of King. And I think one of the most impressive things in this fight, besides that elbow, is just the ability of the power she brings with her ground and pound inside the guard. A lot of people can't bring that type of fury in the closed guard of their opponent, but Kayla Harrison, very dangerous to say the least.
And I think, I love the way she hits the body. I think a lot of that also comes with the confidence of knowing if you get tied up like that, she has the experience, she has, you know, the know-how to get out of trouble there. And you can really let go with your hands if you know how to get out of submissions. You can, you know, just have a lot of confidence in yourself there.
Courtney King doing a nice job trying to tie up Kayla's wrist here, but Kayla just so powerful. And the way she rolls over with that elbow, it doesn't matter if you have your wrist trapped, that elbow is still going to land.
Yeah, I was impressed that Courtney King really got in her face at the beginning of this round, but I think at this point she should think more disengaging, not keeping that that guard locked up, but actually getting back to her feet, working her way back up now.
And Courtney King is definitely here for a fight, and she has one on her hands with Kayla Harrison inside her guard. See if she can try to make something happen. Looks like she's on her left hip, maybe trying to grab the neck or maybe Kimura.
Blood can be an excellent lubricant on the ground in terms of it's really hard to hold on to those submissions hard. You know, it slides through the gloves, slides across the skin, and so it does favor escaping submissions.
It's much more greasy and oily feeling than you would imagine it to be. Oh, wow.
Trying to grab a hold of the neck here is King. She's been able to slow down the pace and slow down the pace enough for Marcy La Silva to intervene and stand them back up.
Felt like she was landing a lot of shots and I'm a little surprised by that.
But this is where King wants to be in this fight, on her feet, peppering, moving in and out, really getting that flurry, trying to get Kayla moving back. Nice shot.
I feel like she's moving in but not out, Julie. I would like her to do both.
I agree with you. I think not just moving forward there, but
lovely.
High amplitude takedown there for Kayla Harrison. 2 minutes remain here in round number two.
And, you know, in cases like this, I don't think closed guard is what you want. I think you want to use your guard as a brace to get up. You want to push her away. Any kind of brace on her, any kind of, you know, pushing on the hips or putting your knees together on the chest and shoving. Yeah, like this. You need to get out of there because you're right in her power zone.
Courtney King is very good on the ground, but she needs to be on top. She's got to disengage, you know, potentially get it back to the feet. And, you know, as I said in the keys, find her moment to potentially take it to the mat and get that dominant position. But, man, tough task when you're facing someone like Kayla Harrison here.
Harrison steps over into mount. She went for an arm bar earlier. We'll see if she tries to go for it again.
She's isolating that left arm of Courtney.
I like the way she's targeting the ear right there. I think that's, you know, it's a really good way to disrupt somebody's equilibrium and just make them frustrated.
And looking at Courtney King, I mean, she may be better suited to sort of give that arm to Kayla Harrison so she can try to roll through and escape. But right now, Harrison electing to just punish her with some strikes here. Flattened out now is Courtney King, and that cut is wide open again.
It is. And, you know, I think with King, it's more about she just wants to stay in motion at this point, and staying in motion might slow down some of the ground and pound, slow down some of the damage. I don't think offering up her arm would keep Harrison from punching her or elbowing her in the face.
She's close to giving up her back here, is King.
You mentioned close to giving up her back. I mean, now crucifix position here by Kayla Harrison. Can she put on the finishing touches? A touch over 10 seconds.
Oh, wow.
That's a wrap. It is done. Kayla Harrison.
Johnson has arrived at 145 pounds.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes officially 4 minutes, 48 seconds. Round number two, stoppage due to strikes for your winner by TKO and still undefeated, Kayla Harrison.
A world-class judoka